Hi friends, welcome to day number 2. We are in 1 Peter chapter 5 and I'm ready to begin. Let's pray. Father, we praise you today. You are our chief shepherd, Lord. You are the good shepherd and you lead and guide and direct your sheep. And God, we just take a moment to turn to you and ask that you would lead us into your word. We want to be more like you. Thanks, God. All right, so here we are, page 132 of the workbook, verse 5. All right, likewise, you who are younger, be subject to the elders. Clothe yourselves, all of you, with humility toward one another. For God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time he may exalt you, casting all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. All right, short but beautiful. Love these verses. And I'll tell you, you know, I'm just going to jot this down right now. 3 times I see this word humble or humility, and I do think this is related to the main point. And I wonder, doggone it, I wish you could be sitting right here. I'd like to know what you put down as the main point for today. I put we are all to wear or tie on humility. And so, let's just maybe go backwards and look at some observations. Number one, I looked at who Peter is talking to. He's talking to the younger, and it just caused me to ask, okay, you know, yesterday we were talking about how he was addressing the elders, and so it made me ask, are elders older? And it kind of looks like this is true. And I mean, for sure, an elder would be older in the faith, but it does seem that Peter uses a word that means the younger of two people. So, what is Peter saying here? He's saying, well, the younger ought to follow the shepherding of the elders. This all ties together with yesterday's lesson. But then he has a good word for all of us. And he says, clothe yourselves, all of you, with humility toward one another. For God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. And friends, here's where, you know, okay, so we think we know what it means to clothe ourselves, and I think in this instance, it's similar to what we might picture in our minds. But I did look it up in the Strong's Concordance, and it means to become, to tie on. And the cross references are beautiful. The cross references take us directly to Jesus. And I'm hoping that maybe you found one of these or dug into it to see. There's one in Matthew 20, verses 26 and 27. There's another one in John 3, verses 4 and 5. And then there's John 13, 14. And I'm going to land here in John where we see Jesus rise up from supper. He laid aside his outer garments and he took a towel and tied that towel around him. And then in verse 14, he says, if then your Lord and teacher have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. That's touching my heart today. Peter's been saying all along, look, Jesus Christ is our example. He is who we are to follow. And so here he is using Jesus as our example for humility. I mean, he doesn't have to say like Jesus Christ, but the cross reference makes it clear. We are to clothe ourselves with humility. So, friends, what is humility? Some of these words that we don't use every day, I really recommend looking up in a Bible dictionary or the concordance. It's an attitude of, it really is, it's this attitude of valuing ourselves appropriately. I would say valuing or assessing ourselves appropriately, especially in light of our sinfulness. So that's humility. And to be humble is to be brought low. It's to take on a lesser rank than it's to become reduced in rank, character, or status. And that's exactly Jesus's example to us, right? He humbles himself. He humbled himself, taking on flesh. So this also caused me to look up proud. Like, I think we know what proud means, but sometimes the word really cuts when we dig a little deeper into it. And proud does mean arrogant. It means having or showing feelings of unwarranted importance out of overbearing pride. And I think what Peter is saying here, well, okay, let's see what you think. You know, here at the end of these three verses, he tags on this line, verse 7, saying, casting all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. And again, this word cast has to do with clothing. It means take it off, and not only take it off, but it actually means to put it on forcefully, to put it on somebody else forcefully, as if hurling it on them. And so Peter is saying we need to take this off. And remember back in chapter 2, this is on page 82 of the workbook. In verse 1, he says, so put away all malice and all deceit and hypocrisy and envy and all slander. He says, put away all these things. And again, it's like taking off a piece of clothing, like put it away. And I think all of those things are related to pride, right? Are related to arrogance, are related to self and caring about ourselves first. And maybe this feeling of importance for ourselves. I think maybe a little bit of that comes out of fear, right? That comes out of fear. And so Peter is saying, put all of this away. Put all of this away. And he's getting at the root of our hearts. What's at the root? Fear, our anxieties, our cares, and our cares about ourselves. And Peter says, no, look, cast all of these. Put these on Jesus because he cares for you. He is concerned for you. You are important to him. You are valuable to him. You are relevant to him today. Friends, I hope that you'll take a moment or two or a little bit longer to just ponder all of that with the Lord. What does that mean for us today to follow in the example of Jesus Christ and his humility and to trust that he really does care for us? All right, friends, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow.